All right, so I'm Rob. I'm a senior software engineer at Netflix. Let's just get started. Hey, I'm going to talk a little bit about where Temporal is used inside of Netflix and what we've done so far to integrate it into the Netflix platform. Temporal is currently used in two different places. One is Spinnaker, Netflix's CI and CD product. That's the product that I've been working on since I've been at Netflix. We first started with migrating all of our cloud operations. So if you're unfamiliar with Spinnaker, it's a multi-cloud continuous delivery platform. And so we have dozens and dozens of cloud operations that are written for various cloud providers, AWS, Titus, another cloud called CCAS inside of Netflix. And we have abstractions above those that allow people to interact with these various cloud providers in the same way. So that had its own orchestration system that we had built in-house, and we have kind of gotten tired of writing our own plumbing. And have decided to level up the abstractions that we're dealing with inside of Spinnaker so we can focus on innovating our main charter, which is continuous delivery. We're also going to be changing many, many other things inside of Spinnaker as well to use Temporal, but that's a little bit down the road. The other team that's using Temporal is our TDI. They've written a Flink Control Plane that allows them to do red, black, or blue-green deployments of Flink, the task manager, the job manager, all that stuff in a safe and controlled manner. And that used to be, yet again, another homegrown system that used Zookeeper and a whole bunch of coordination, and we've just been able to simplify it quite a lot by just the workflow abstraction. Inside of Netflix, we just adopted Temporal at the beginning of this year. We are deployed into two different regions in three different environments, test, staging, and prod. In US West 2 and US 1, we use Temporal's XCC replication. We deploy straight onto EC2 VMs, and we use MySQL RDS. We would obviously prefer to use Cassandra. However, due to some internal constraints, we can't depend on other teams' software because we are a tier zero service. So we use MySQL RDS instead. We have Chaos Monkey enabled for all the different services. So throughout the day, Chaos Monkey will be randomly terminating the matching service, the history service, all that kind of stuff. And it's just our way of ensuring that Temporal is sound given various failure scenarios. We also have done some regional failovers as well. Right now, we have 500,000 production workflows started and completed a day. And we're projecting that to be about 1 million per day by the end of the year. So the Netflix platform, or paved road, is just a foundation of platform services for development and operations of services inside of Netflix. Having any new technology brought into Netflix, it's table stakes to have good integration with these. And so we've extended both Temporal and the SDK for this purpose. As far as Temporal the service goes, we've added dynamic config integration with a service called Fast Properties. This is just a small service that runs on Cassandra that lets us add dynamic config at various constraint levels, all the way from being a global property that affects every application inside of Netflix, which is not the best, all the way down to individual instances. We can target the constraints however we want, and that actually maps very nicely into the dynamic config extension point that Temporal has. We also have authentication through Metatron MTLS. So we extended, I wish I had actually looked at the extensions when I was writing this, but the certificate extension, we've added that and also extended the UI for Wally, which is an authentication proxy. We have a system called Gandalf, which we've extended to extended Temporal to integrate with for authorization as well of namespaces and user groups. We had originally added metrics through DogStatsD, the StatsD integration that comes with Temporal wasn't really working for us. So the fine folks at Temporal were able to open up an extension point for that. You know, we started with DogStatsD, but now have moved to the OTel contributor collector, which just lets us modify what comes out of the Prometheus metrics collector. And then, as I mentioned, we've also forked the UI so that we can integrate with our Wally authentication proxy. And very excited for the new UI so that we don't hopefully need to maintain as aggressive of a fork as we do today. And then the Java SDK, we only use the Java SDK. We don't have Node, we don't have Go or anything like that. Since it's just two teams right now that are using Temporal and we both use the JVM, we're happy with just supporting the Java SDK. We've forked the SDK, which we had to do to shade in our own gRPC and Netty libraries. The Netflix platform has our own particular forks of gRPC and Netty, and using those instead of the OSS ones was required for things to work. That wasn't that big a deal because you can do all kinds of fun stuff with Gradle to replace dependencies. We've also integrated it with Spring Boot so that we have all configuration for workers, their thread pools, activities, all that kind of fun stuff with relatively no configuration. You can just add the dependency and then your application is temporalized. Integrates with service discovery. So if you disable a service inside of Spinnaker or via Spinnaker, that is, it will stop the workers polling and that kind of thing. We also have a traffic routing library that's built on an activity called TaskQueueNamer that lets us dynamically route work either from one cluster that's running in AWS or wherever to another cluster, or alternatively sending production traffic down to our laptops and back, which can be useful for migrations of existing functionality. We've got many, many services inside of Spinnaker, and trying to run all of those on our machine to get an end-to-end experience is tough. So being able to click around inside prod and targeting very specific slices of traffic to send down to your laptop has been useful for just ensuring that the end-to-end experience works well. And then we have also written XCC aware clients. So rather than interacting with the workflow client, the stubs, all those directly, we have providers where people can just say, I'm in this particular namespace, please give me the client for the active temporal cluster and it will provide it to you. Which is pretty necessary as far as running an XDC environment. Shouldn't really be up to developers to know which client to be using. So that's just making life a little bit easier for people. For the future, similar to the XDC clients, it would be nice if we didn't have to have that be an application concern at all. So we've been thinking a little bit about a global XDC proxy that would just implement the Temporal API and do the routing at the service level rather than at the application level. We have a little bit more SDK enhancements to do, namely integrating open tracing with our platform tracing libraries, and then a workflow registry. We are standardizing on Temporal for most extension, like plugin aspects of Spinnaker. And Spinnaker needs to know what workflows are out there for people that are adding new functionality to us. So this will be basically like a plugin repository or what have you that will allow us to query the state of the world inside Netflix and route particular traffic where we need to. And I would just like to plug that we are very interested in one-on-one chats with other companies in the Temporal community. We really like to get deeper into our use cases and talk to other people and how they're approaching continuous delivery or operations of Temporal, or even just use cases totally outside of what we're doing today. It's just a nice way to network and share ideas. So if you're interested, please DM me in Slack. That is it. Thanks.